welcome to one and all. It's a pleasure and it's an honor to invite on board VP Goel Saab, for he's known. Namaste, sir.
Namaskar.
And he's very well known for his work on divisional charts. He is a senior astrologer, written books on many divisional charts. So let's not waste time, go straight to him and ask him what divisional charts mean to him and how he came into working on divisional charts. Sir, a warm welcome to you. A very warm welcome on the channel.
Thank you. Thank you again. Now, see, as in any astrologer, journey has to begin with first step.
Yes,
right? So my journey of my interest in astrology began in 1970 or 71.
That's 45 years ago.
Yes. When a friend of mine taught me how to cast a horoscope. That was the first thing. And we were in the field area of army.
Okay.
So that became our pastime in the evening. Yeah. I will cast the horoscope, meet officers who were without families,
right,
and predict for them, jokingly.
Okay.
And I started learning it. So after some time, when I joined Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan and started teaching also there, then I realized that simply from the horoscope, you cannot predict the microscopic points.
Right.
And why Parasharji has given this thing? You know, in our astrology, Hindu astrology, there are two things which are unique.
Right.
One is our dasha system.
Right.
And the other is vargas.
Right,
divisional charts.
Right.
And without understanding them,
right,
you cannot be a good predictor or a good astrologer or understand the depth.
Yes.
Understand the depth of astrology. And that is why I started working on dashas. My first book was on progressive Yogini dasha.
Okay.
A new method, and that came in 2003. So in 16 years, maybe 10,000 people, 10,000 horoscopes they must have tested.
Okay.
I teach it in every session.
Right.
And brilliant results. Even a first learner can predict with Yogini Dasha, the timing of events. Then the divisional charts, you can predict accurately what is going to happen. So that is why I got interested in this, and to know the depth and the purpose of your life.
Right.
That also is clear from this.
Sir, just a thought and a question here. Can we pinpoint events very, very precisely and time events precisely from the divisional charts?
No, you need dasha also.
Yeah, with the dasha.
With dasha. See, every dasha starts from D1.
Right, sir.
And confirmation is from the divisional charts.
Okay.
So we can treat divisional charts as an individual chart, as I will demonstrate today.
Right, sir.
So, without losing more time,
right,
I think we can come to the topic of
yes.
D10.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. D10 is a very, very important chart. I have used very, very twice.
Right, sir.
Because Parasharji has said D10 is seen for Mahat Phalam. Events or the phalit or the things of big impact, which has got big impact on your life.
Right.
And what is the biggest impact? Is your death and birth.
Right. Yes.
So I even think or consider and are sure that even your death can be predicted from your D10.
Okay.
Because D10 is the chart of your karmas broadly.
Right.
It is your karmas, not only your profession.
Right.
And when your karmas end, that is your death.
Right. Yes.
Because this Kali Yuga is the yuga of karma.
Right.
Right.
Right, sir.
So we consult D10 for very important things in our life.
Thank you, sir.
So you see the importance of D10. I will not go into casting of D10.
Yeah.
But only I want to say that I use Parashar method of casting D10. There are other methods also. But Parashari method has given me good results. Right. So first, let us examine how your karmas will be in this life. What level you can go. What status you can achieve. This is the first tip I am giving. It is a very long chapter, but I will give few tips today.
Right, sir.
Right?
Right, sir.
Okay. This point, please listen carefully. Note down, because you know, there is a saying in Hindi, Poot ke paav palne mein hi dikhte hain. So, when you are born, God has written everything about you.
Right.
And how he starts your cycle is from the dasha, Vimshottari dasha or any other dasha.
Yes.
I use Vimshottari also. The rule is, note down the Nakshatra Lord of moon in your birth chart.
Okay.
This Nakshatra Lord is your Mahadasha?
Yes.
With which you are born?
Yes.
Now check this Nakshatra Lord in your D10.
Okay.
That will tell you how you will do your karmas in this life, up to what level you will go, what problems you will face, what is the aim of your life.
Yes.
See, Anuradha, this is a very important point.
Yes, sir.
This is very important. Simply, at a glance, our topic is how to analyze D10. So, at a glance, as soon as the person comes, you see the Mahadasha of birth. Take that Lord and go to D10. And examine it. It should not be afflicted by malefics. It should not be 6, 8, 12. It should be in Kendra Trikon. If it is exalted, perfect, very good. Even if it is debilitated, it is a special status that you will start from scratch and rise. If Nich Bhang is there, it's wonderful. If it is in third house, 11th house, a gainful life. Like this, you can analyze.
So what if
any
it's retrograde?
House.
What if it is retrograde?
No problem. It is strong. Retrograde planet is Shakti.
Cheshtabal. Yes, sir.
Cheshtabal is there. So he will do lot of efforts in his life. Now you can check in all these horoscopes which you have selected.
Yes.
I have not selected them.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You have selected them.
Yes, sir.
Check it each one by one.
Yes.
Which one you are displaying first?
Sir, so we first move with Bill Gates.
Bill Gates. So Bill Gates, what is the nakshatra, the birth dasha?
Sir, his birth nakshatra is Uttarabhadrapada.
So Uttarabhadrapad?
Yes, sir. Saturn.
That is a Saturn nakshatra. Now you check it in D10.
Saturn is in his seventh house.
He is Lagna Lord.
Yes, sir.
Don't forget that.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Not in a very good house. It is the house of moon.
Yes, sir.
But the karma is strengthened. What Saturn is in the partners, business partners, associates with depth in his profession, there you will succeed. It is a good life. Professionally, he does charities also.
Yes.
He has risen high in his life. So you can see, because it is Saturn Nakshatra. Second chart, you can verify anywhere.
Sir, before I move further, I'd just like to ask one question here. Sir, in this chart, we also see that Saturn is exalted, Sun is debilitated. But apart from
Sun
that,
is
in the D1, in the D1, we see that Saturn is exalted.
Exalted, okay.
And in the D7, sir, it is in the seventh house. For Saturn.
In D7.
Yeah, sorry, in D10.
In D10.
It is in the seventh house.
Yes.
Sir, according to another bull, that is Big Bull, it is said that Saturn gets Big Bully in
seventh. I will tell you one more thing. Any chart, if Saturn is in seventh house, it is treated as exalted.
Okay, sir.
Because in Kal Purush,
it is exalted in the
exalted sense. And that is why he gets respect in profession.
Okay.
In D9, if Saturn is in seventh house, that person will get respect in in-law's house.
Okay.
Yeah, now again, let me tell you, when this flow comes, I am speaking. But when I speak in English, Hindi, maybe I will repeat something different.
Yes, sir. Please. So, people who can understand both the languages,
yes,
we request you to watch both the videos so you get the maximum out of it.
Okay. Now, this is Alzheimer.
Yes, sir.
His moon is?
His moon is 20 degrees in Hasta Nakshatra. So it is
Hasta Nakshatra.
Virgo, so it's in Hasta Nakshatra.
Hasta Nakshatra.
Yes.
So we check moon in his chart.
Yes, sir.
Moon is debilitated?
Yes, sir.
In sixth house?
Yes, sir.
But with cancellation of debilitation? Right?
No, sir, it's with Saturn in the sixth house.
It is with Saturn, aspected by?
By Mars.
By Mars.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So it is a cancellation.
Yes, sir.
So the starting is at a low level.
Yes, yes.
And then you grow after hardship.
Extreme.
After great efforts.
Yes, sir. Yes.
You see it? It's not a silver spoon in his mouth.
Right. Right.
So even this tip, just a small tip, how to see it. Right? Next.
So we can, so then I have a chart of Rajneesh Osho.
Osho. Osho's moon is?
Osho's moon is in Purva Ashada. So Venus.
Purva Ashada.
Yes, sir.
Venus. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now check Venus.
11th house in D10.
It is in 11th house. Aspected by
Jupiter, retrograde Jupiter.
Jupiter and Saturn.
And Saturn, yes, sir.
Again, full life, full of wisdom, deep analysis, philosophy.
And construction of an institute.
Yeah, do you need any more proof?
No, sir. That's a beautiful one. Very beautiful one and a long way to go. I don't think many of us could have even thought in that.
Then comes, next is?
Aditya Vikram Birla. He's a
Aditya Vikram
industrialist.
Birla. Yes. It is Mars.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Right?
Yeah.
Mars is in 11th house.
Yes, sir.
In enemy sign.
Yes, sir.
Has got no other aspect.
Yeah.
Okay? No aspect.
No, sir.
So, he has a very easy life, so to say.
Yes, sir.
Born in a big family in 11th house. And that too in debilitated sign.
Okay.
No.
Not a debilitated.
Enemy sign.
Enemy house and retrograde. But sir,
enemy house and
retrograde. Retrograde gave him the cheshta bal or the ability to go.
Effort he gave. But if it was, now there is no chart we had seen who is not successful.
Right, sir.
So, if you come across other charts, those who are not lucky to be successful, you will find them in a bad place under malefic influences. That is what God has written about your karmas when you are born.
Right.
Isn't it?
Yes.
So, this was my first tip.
Right, sir.
Do we continue another tip or?
So we can move on.
Okay. Now, the second point, which more people are interested, is what business or how my business will be, how my profession will go.
Right.
So for that, I want to clarify that D10 has to play dual role. And that is why it is a difficult chart to analyze.
Okay.
What I say, Lagna is the, from Lagna, if we see, all your karmas of life.
Okay.
When we come to the profession or your vocation,
right,
then we make 10th house as Lagna.
Okay.
One more point here.
Yes, sir.
There are three things. One is house, another is house lord.
Right.
And the third is Karak.
Right.
Everybody knows it, but
yes, sir.
They do not know what is the application of each. What to see from which.
Yeah, that is also very important.
Yeah. House is the promise.
Okay.
And house lord is the way you do it.
Okay.
Because that is action. He is the lord.
Yes.
Lord of that house. So how you maintain your house depends on your strength.
Right.
And last is Karak. Karak is the beauty. In Hindi, I give you better meaning. That is Sundarta of the house.
Right.
Suppose Venus is good. Karak in Navamsha, Venus is good.
Yes, sir.
Your wife or husband can be like a buffalo. But if Venus is good, that shows the beauty that character. Okay. That she will look after you. It does not give you the beauty, facial beauty. It is the inner beauty. So in D10 also, it is the inner beauty. So another quick method is to see the lagna of D10.
Right.
If lagna is connected with its own lord, with benefits, then you have a desire to work. And the lagna lord shows how you will do your work.
Right.
For example, the Bill Gates chart is open.
Yes.
Lagna is aspected by its lord.
By Jupiter.
It is aspected by Jupiter. It is aspected by Mars.
Yes.
A very strong will to work. He wants to work.
Yes.
How he will work is Saturn. Saturn is not aspected by any planet.
Right.
No planet is with it.
Saturn is aspected by Rahu.
No, Rahu, I don't take the aspects.
Okay, sir.
If you want, you can take it. So, Saturn, there is no connection. So, he wants to work independently.
Right.
Hard work, Saturn condition. Like a tapasvi, he works.
Right.
Okay. And I am not taking karaks here because there are so many karaks for 10th house and people will get confused.
Two of the three of the karaks are aspecting that house only because Sun is sitting there. Saturn is aspecting, Jupiter is aspecting.
But I am saying as a first step, restrict it to the lagna. First step is lagna. If lagna is afflicted, Rahu-Ketu is sitting there or something, he does not want to work. There is no desire to work. Okay?
Yes, sir.
If
take one more example of Alzheimer.
Anybody.
Alzheimer.
What is the... lagna. Lagna is occupied by Rahu and Sun. Not much desire to work is present. You understand?
Yes, sir.
There is no inner zest of doing any work. Aayega, aayega, kar lenge. Okay? But Sun is sitting there.
Yes, sir.
His desire to work is with authority. Now Rahu is with Sun. You will say it is eclipsed. No. Rahu gives material desires to anybody, any planet. Right? And the Lagna Lord, Mercury,
is in the 11th house.
Is in 11th house. Not aspected by anybody. Is there any aspect? No.
No, sir.
Okay, so again he is also independent and gainful. He will get fruits of his efforts. Understand?
Sir, he was working with patients in government hospitals, facing a lot of issues there, and yet persisted in working there. And then he started long afterwards. He got his gain.
His recognition. Yes. So ultimately, this is the desire. How he will achieve in a gain, resulting in a gain, without any malefic aspect. Easily he will do. He will is not perturbed. If there was a malefic aspect
on Mercury,
then he will say he will face difficulties. He has to work hard. These malefics, they make you work hard. Benefics, they don't make you work hard. Easily it is achieved. You don't struggle.
It's a very beautiful point, sir.
Right. Next. Okay, let us examine in all these. Next is Birla.
Yes, sir.
Aditya Birla. Now, Lagna is?
Scorpio.
Scorpio.
And Lagna Lord is sitting in enemy house in the
air. No, Scorpio is not aspected by anybody.
Yes, sir. Scorpio is not aspected. Neither is Mars aspected.
Okay. Hmm. So, Scorpio, it is an average situation, I will say.
Hmm.
If the work comes, I will work. If it does not come, I will not work.
Hmm.
Right. There is no inner desire to do hard work.
Right.
Then the Lagna Lord is also not aspected, but it is in enemy house. It is in enemy house. Like Mercury also was in enemy house.
Yes, sir.
For Alzheimer. So you have to face a lot of enemies, but you will success. You will get success because its placement in 11th house and no other aspect.
Sir, can I ask you a question here?
Yeah.
Sir, Mars is retrograde. So does that also mean that he
Chesta.
Will... Yes, in his enemy's house. So when there is competition, he will work better.
Yes. It is sixth lord also.
Yes, sir. So when there is competition, he will definitely do,
Do a better job. So it is Lord shows how you will do your work. See, very simple. Nothing. You don't need all the rules of the world. How to see a D10 chart or any Varga chart. Any Varga.
Yes.
If in Navamsha, Lagna is having malefic connection, you don't have a desire to marry. Simple, straight. Okay.
Very beautiful points. People can call it subtle points, but you know, the subtle points define the charts much better than the apparent ones.
No. You don't have to remember them also.
Yes, sir.
Easily applicable. Easily. See the birth dasha. Next, analyze the Lagna and Lagna Lord. And you are done. So you get a picture, broad picture of your career, of your life. How your life is going to be.
Sir, thank you so much. It was beautiful.
My pleasure.
Thank you, sir.
No, I don't. I want to share everything with everybody.
We will be continuing on with this series with sir. So if you've liked the video, if you have your questions, please do write to us so that you know how you have found the approach in divisional charts. We know many people nowadays want to be very sure about what they should pursue, how they should pursue, and how much can they reach. So these two clues give you enough reason to dwell in your D10 and get back to us on that.
Okay, thank you.